Hi everyone, and welcome. Today, we will successfully implement external hysteresis using the TLV3604. In this video, we will discuss the theory behind implementing external hysteresis with this device. We will derive equations for the hysteresis thresholds, and then we will test them with a simulation. Let's get started. This is the circuit configuration we will use to implement external hysteresis with LVDS outputs. To solve for the thresholds, we must identify the threshold voltage node and solve for when the output is both high and low. To do this, we can isolate the lower output terminal, Q bar, which is denoted by this red box. After isolating the Q bar output, we will see that the voltage transfer curve at this output exhibits the behavior of an inverting comparator. Now we have to identify the threshold voltage node. After doing this, we can analyze the circuit when the Q bar output is in its high LVDS state and its low LVDS state. Let us first consider when the Q bar output is in its high state and has a value of Q high. We can use superposition techniques to solve for the threshold voltage at this point in the VTC. Our first step when solving for the threshold voltage using superposition is to ground each of the voltages contributing to that threshold voltage. For our example, step one includes shorting VREF to ground to solve for the contribution to the threshold voltage from Q high. As you can see, the equation shown below illustrates Q high's contribution to the threshold voltage. Step 2 in our superposition solution is to short the Q high voltage to ground and solve for the voltage contribution to the threshold voltage from VREF. As you can see, the equation shown below illustrates VREF's contribution to the threshold voltage. Now we can combine our two superposition equations to get our result shown in equation 1. Equation 1 is the equation that we will use to establish the upper hysteresis threshold voltage. We must now solve for the threshold voltage when the Q bar output is in its low state and has a value of Q low. Using the same techniques shown in previous slides, we can solve for the lower threshold voltage, VTL. This value is illustrated by equation 2. An important observation to make is that the total hysteresis voltage, VHIS, is equal to the upper threshold voltage, VTH, minus the lower threshold voltage, VTL. Using this definition for the hysteresis window voltage, we subtract equation 2 from equation 1 to arrive at equation 3. And as you can see, the hysteresis window voltage is equal to the output differential voltage multiplied by R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Using these three equations, it is now possible to implement external hysteresis using the TLV3604. After manipulating equation 3, we now have an equation for R1 as it relates to R2, the output differential voltage, and the hysteresis window voltage. Using this new equation for R1, we can plug in an assumed resistance value for R2, our output differential voltage, and our desired hysteresis window voltage to solve for R1. After calculating the value for R1, we can then plug it into either equation 1 or equation 2 to solve for the necessary reference voltage to produce these hysteresis results. I would now like to highlight the importance of selecting R2 when using the TLV3604 with LVDS outputs. The TLV3604 typically supplies 3.5 milliamps of current through the 100 ohm output resistor. A good rule of thumb is to have 100 times less current through the feedback loop completed by R2. This means that the common mode voltage divided by R2 should be less than 35 microamps. This will minimize leakage current through R2, reducing the impact on the LVDS output levels. For our simulated example, we have the design parameters shown in this table with a 50 millivolt hysteresis window. Using these design parameters and the equations we previously derived, R2 was selected to be 50 kiloohms, R1 was calculated to be 8.33 kiloohms, and Bref was calculated to be 150 millivolts. After replacing all theoretical resistor values with standard ones, this was our simulated voltage transfer curve for our circuit. This tutorial showed you how to successfully configure the TLV3604 for external hysteresis. If you would like additional part information, please navigate to our TLV3604 product folder with the URL in red. If you would like a single resistor solution, then the TLV3605 with a dedicated hysteresis pin is the best option. Thank you for watching.